Hello there and welcome to the Business Roundup this week. My name is Viola Xasia and the team and I are always following events happening in the world of business in order to bring to you the latest. I welcome once again, and on the set with me is Paul Busharizi. He is a business journalist with a new vision and is also an economic analyst able to dissect some of these events happening in the world of business. So Paul, thank you so much for joining us tonight on this set for the Business Roundup. Let's start off with the events where we had the president speak about investment with the Ugandans living in the diaspora, the United States and UK. So what are some of those areas you believe should have a huge return and also profit for the investors in case their money is channeled to that direction?
I mean, off the top of my head, there are a lot of places, a lot of sectors with deficits that things are not enough in there. Off the top of my head, I just think of education. We need more schools. It was just evident in the last uptake of S1s, where we, for the first time maybe in a long time, we had a double uptake. The school classrooms and the infrastructure of S1 was just not enough to take care of the classes. So clearly there's a gap there. Health, I think we need a bit more specialized, services. You can go in there. Housing. There's a need for housing, even all up and down the scale, from low cost housing to the extremely luxurious. That's there. General trade. There's always something to buy and sell in this country. So there's so much deficit in this country that it's a no-brainer. Investment is the possibility for investment are quite.
Part of investment usually in Uganda, the worry usually circles around taxing, and we had government come out just recently to mention lifting some of the tax waivers as requested by Parliament in order to reduce the number of people having holidays and, you know, escaping taxing in the country. So talk about the part of URA and investment in Uganda. How best can people have a conducive environment to be able to invest and have their returns?
Well, tax waivers is not why investors come to your country or invest. Investors invest because they see an opportunity. Tax waivers or no tax waivers. The local Ugandans have invested for decades in this economy without tax waivers in many instances.
So that question takes us now into the report that was released by the Ministry of Finance together with the National Household Survey. This report says that many Ugandans could fall back into poverty, especially due to the effects of COVID-19. Now, before the lockdown, they had a belief that poverty could have as easily fallen below 20%. But as soon as the lockdowns came through, it went to 21%, but it had been 18 in around 2018. So that shows you that there was a bit of a dance back and forth for percentages, increase and drop. So that shows you that indeed most Ugandans are vulnerable. And this report suggests because of economic shocks. However, some analysts came out to say that the picture on ground is worse than what the figures are suggesting. And we have Dr. Fred Muhumza from Makere. He's an analyst as well, economic analyst. He says that this picture is just wrongly represented and it's worse what's on ground. He also faults the government for not doing enough, you know, bringing up programs to help Ugandans. What did you think about the programs government has come up with to help Ugandans?
No, I mean, we can't make small of this subject. People are suffering. It's a hard situation now. The government has cut spending, and once government cuts spending, the whole economy suffers for it. Of course, as you said, we've just come out of COVID. The economy is still trying to recover. We can't make light of it. It's a very hard situation for most people. And those numbers, as you described by the Ministry of Finance, show that people living in poverty has increased since COVID. That being said, when Ugandans, maybe I'll speak for Ugandans, when Ugandans are in a hard place, they don't lie down and die. They find means. And, you know, I'm sure out there Ugandans are finding means to survive, because you know, you don't hear of Ugandans committing suicide, for example. It's negligible. They find ways to survive. You know, there's a big statistic that 90% of Ugandan companies do not reach their fifth birthday. But somebody asked me, so when they collapse, what do you think happens to those guys? They go and start another business. Yeah, they don't just lie down and die. So I have great faith in the Ugandan people. This is a temporary situation. They'll get over it. and they'll be good to go when things improve.
All right. So thank you so much, Paul, for making time. We shall talk to you again next week. And thank you, too, for making time to watch the Business Roundup this week. We shall see you again next week. You've had clarity of what's happening. Everything that pops up, we shall be sure to bring it to you every Friday on the news. I'm Vaila Sasia. Back to the news.